Hello students, in this video we are going to see the grammar chapter 1 parts of speech. How many parts of speech are there in English? Let's see. First of all, we shall know what is parts of speech. Words are divided into different types according to their use and function in a sentence. It is called parts of speech. The same word can be used as a noun or as a verb or as an adjective or as an adverb depending upon its use and function in a sentence. The meaning of the same word will vary according to its usage and function. We can see some examples. Mr. Raju reached the top of the hill, which means here a top means situated on the top of something. So here it is used as an adjective. See the second sentence. She came top in her English exam. Here top means first. It is used as an adverb. The children are playing top. Here top is used as a noun. Like that, the ship crashed on the rocks. Here rocks means the noun. Please rock the cradle. In this sentence, the same word rock has a different function. Rock is used as a verb here. Okay, so the same word can be used as any part of speech depending upon its usage and function in the sentence. Okay. How many parts of speech are there in English? There are 8. They are noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. Let's see them one by one. The first part of speech, noun. Noun is a naming word. A noun is used as the name of a person, place, things, animals, or an idea. Example, names of persons, John, Ovia, boy, doctor, all these are names of persons. And the second one, names of places. Pudukkottai, Chennai, Gordon, Delhi, Calcutta, everything. Okay. The names of things. Pen, pencil, notebook, table, fruit, cell phone, everything. And it can be used to name animals also. Cow, snake, dog, peacock, all these are names given for animals. And names given for ideas. Example, poverty, obedience, friendship. Okay, so in general, noun is a naming word. The second one is pronoun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun, or it replaces the noun. In other words, it replaces the noun. Example, John is absent because he is ill. How the sentence would be, John is absent because John is ill. But instead of using the same name again in the same sentence, we can avoid it and we can use the pronoun he. Like that, Jasmine is my daughter and she is doing college first year. Like that, I, we, you, he, she, it, they, all are pronouns. Yes, the next one is an adjective. Adjective describes or adds something to the meaning of a noun or pronoun. It adds some more meaning to the noun or pronoun. See the example, Lalita is a beautiful girl. So here the word beautiful, it adds some more meaning to the noun Lalita. Like that, Mohana is an intelligent girl. Okay. Here the word intelligent, it adds some more additional meaning to the noun Mohana. Like that, it is sweet. So, in general, the words for adjectives, they can describe about the size, shape, texture, order, taste, appearance. Okay, so we shall see some examples. Size and shape adjectives, tiny, long, oval, short, like that. Texture, smooth, soft, prickly. Order or taste, bitter, sweet, so. Appearance, handsome, beautiful, bright. All these comes under adjective. Okay, the next one, verb. It is an important part of speech. A verb is an action word. It expresses a state of being or it shows possession or ownership. So, without a verb, a sentence cannot be completed. Okay, so verb is an important thing. And see the example, Mr. Peter has bought a car. Rosie ate an apple. The action. Okay, has the possession. It shows possession also. Action words such as speak, ask, write, run, dance, or verbs under action. And state of being verbs, be, am, or is, was, were. They show the state of being. And possession or ownership, have, has, had. They show the possession or ownership. Okay, next we shall see adverb. An adverb modifies verb, adjective or another adverb. An adverb answers the questions where, when, how and how often. So, adverb, it modifies verb. It adds some more meaning, some additional meaning to the verb. Okay. Generally, it answers the questions where, when, how and how often. Let's see some examples. I met her in Chennai. Here, Chennai answers the question where. I received his letter last week. Last week, here answers the question when. Madhuri danced well. Here, well answers the question, how. The doctor advised me to take the tablets twice in a week. Here, twice in a week answers the question, how often. So, like that, some adverbs we shall see. Answers for where, Chennai, bus stand, away, inside. When, yesterday, morning, before, soon. Answers for the question, how, well, loudly, quickly, fast. Yes, we shall see the next part of speech. Preposition. Yeah, preposition shows the relationship between nouns or verbs and nouns. So, in general, they show the relationship between two things. The cow. There is a cow in the garden. So, So here we could see two different nouns, cow, garden. What is the connection between two of them? The word in connects them. Okay. I kept it under the cot. The train went through the tunnel. He was sitting beside me. So the words in, under, through, beside, they show the relationship. Okay. For example, the book is on the table. The book is one thing. The table is another thing. What is the connection between two things? On connects these table and the book. Okay. On shows the connection between the table and the book. The book is on the table. Okay. So, like that, a preposition shows the relationship between two things. Nouns or verbs and nouns. Okay. Let's move to the next one. Conjunctions. A conjunction joins two words or two sentences. Conjunctions are joining words. Okay. Jasmine and Glory are my friends. So, here and joins Jasmine and Glory. Though he ran fast, he could not catch the train. So, here he ran fast one sentence, he could not catch the train another sentence. How to connect these two? By putting the word though, we can connect the two different sentences into one. Raghavan is absent because he is ill. Okay, here the joining word is because. So, in general, a conjunction is a connecting word. It joins two words or two sentences. Interjection. An interjection expresses some sudden feelings or emotions. Okay, the words which we use out of emotions, out of feelings or emotions are called interjections. Example, wow, bravo, alas. These words expresses some sort of feeling or emotions. Wow, how beautiful it is. Bravo, you have done it. Alas, we lost the game. Okay, so the words which show the feelings or emotions are called interjections. Let's summarize what we have learnt. Noun is a naming word. Pronoun replaces or substitutes noun. Adjective. Adjective qualifies noun or pronoun. Verb. Verb is an action word. It expresses state of being or shows possession or ownership. Adverb. Adverb defines the verb. Adjective or another adverb. Okay. Preposition. Preposition shows relationship between two things. Nouns are verbs and nouns. Conjunction. Conjunction is a connecting word. Conjunction is a connecting word connecting two words or sentences. Interjection, it expresses sudden emotions or feeling. Okay. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.